Good Morning Bay Street is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit theuptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Thursday, February 25th, 2010. In the pre-market this morning, we've got futures down below fair value, so we are expecting some selling at the open on Thursday morning. Now, yesterday's trading activity can be best described as a day of indecision or an inside day. It's where the range of the trading day fit within the previous day's range. So we couldn't take out the previous day's high, couldn't take out the previous day's low. So while the TSX was down on the day, hey, it was an inside day. Energy stocks, it was an inside day. Financial stocks, inside day. Now, we did see continued weakness in gold stocks and material sector, but the other major indexes that we follow had an inside day. Now, the Venture Exchange, we're looking for a daily close below 1500 to give us a sell signal. Canadian dollar, right on the cusp of a daily sell signal. Gold is now on a daily sell signal. Crude oil is still holding up very well up there at 80 bucks. Natural gas, I'm going to get ready to be a buyer of natural gas at some point in the very near future. Natural gas, when you look at the market thermometer indicator, we're back down at the bottom of the range again. Last time we were there, we had a nice pickup. Obviously not, they certainly don't all work. We had nice pickup back here. But what we're looking at is risk reward, the risk of being a buyer after getting a buy signal, not just being a buyer where we are right now, because we could certainly go down and retest this recent low. But certainly there's some support right, we're at support right here from this previous low. Risk reward is we're looking for a low risk opportunity. We find them down at the bottom of the range here when we actually do get a buy signal. The high risk opportunities, of course, are up at the top of the range. The markets can continue to go higher when they're up here, but you're just taking more risk. So it all depends on how you feel. If you want to take lots of risk, then you chase stocks that are making new highs. If you want to do low risk, you chase stocks that have just recently made new lows and have started to turn around. Taking a look at some stocks in the news this morning. We got earnings from CIBC. Yesterday was a bearish reversal day for this stock. Daily close below 66 would give us a new sell signal. Probably won't see that on Thursday. Magna reported this morning, and this stock's kind of odd. Been trading sideways for weeks. It did that previously. It's like the stock moves on news and then stops moving right after. If things are good, you really want to see a breakout above 62.50 on Thursday to tell us something new is happening. Otherwise, a breakdown would take us back down to this previous area of support right in here. Tim Hortons also reported, and it's certainly on a nice big buy signal. We're right up at an area where 1, 2, 3 times before we reversed, and so we'll have to see what happens today. I would expect this particular stock to move lower after today's news. Taking a look at the 60-minute charts for Thursday's trading activity, the TSX is using the hourly flypaper channel as support at the present time. We need an hourly close above 11,570 on Thursday to give us an intraday buy signal. For energy stocks, they're slightly below the flypaper channel, a bit weaker. An hourly close above 284.20 would give us an intraday buy signal on Thursday. Financial stocks above the hourly flypaper channel, obviously this is a stronger sector. And we need an hourly close above 175.12 to confirm an intraday buy signal on Thursday. Looking at the gold sector, certainly weaker, farther away from the hourly flypaper channel and moving lower. An hourly close above 314 on Thursday would give us an intraday buy signal. And materials, again, below the flypaper channel and moving away, a sign of weakness, of course. And an hourly close above 323 on Thursday would give us an intraday buy signal for the materials sector. Okay, that's all for Thursday morning, folks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you again on Friday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.